SANFL fans will need to decide where their allegiances lie when the Crows enter their reserves team into the local league. An historic vote allowing an AFL club to join the 136-year-old competition from next year. Nick Wood explains.
Less than 24 hours after the landmark decision to allow the Crows reserves to join the SANFL competition, and football fans are claiming it as a win.
It'll keep my interest a little bit more in the SANFL.
It's better for the club development, it's better for the footballers, and it ultimately it's better for the public.
Just another reason to bit of banter with the family.
The Crows reserves will enter the local league from next year and will be committed until 2029.
This has enormous benefits for us, all our players playing together as a team, playing to our game plan, being coached by our coaches.
But not everyone is enthusiastic about the move. South Adelaide and Central District issuing online statements to their supporters today, revealing both clubs voted against the proposal. The Panthers feared the league's integrity would be compromised, while the Bulldogs stated there were still too many unanswered concerns. However, both promised to lend their full support now the decision had been made. Just 2 weeks ago, Chief Executive Stephen Trigg declared the Crows would only make the move into the SANFL if all local clubs were on board.
The next thing you need is unanimous support, because that's going to create the healthiest situation for growth and the integrity of the competition that everyone craves for.
But when it came to the crunch, they were happy to accept the split 6-2 vote.
I'm assured that all eight clubs are unanimous in their support now that the vote has taken place, and we just want to work with all eight clubs.
Ports declined the same invitation for a standalone reserves team for now.
If we run with the status quo, that's okay, we've said that. But in 2015, we need to have our own team.
Nick Wood, 10 News.